Would it surprise you to learn that one of the great saints of the Orthodox Church is actually a Pope of Rome? Welcome back, Neophytes. I'm Athan Green, and this is Saint of the Month. We live in an age where the Christian world is highly divided between Eastern Orthodox, Roman Catholics, Pentecostals, Evangelicals, and everything in between. It can be hard for us to imagine a world in which there were no such denominations. Well, for the first four centuries, that was just the case. East and West had expressed the faith with their own cultural flavors, to be sure, but at this point in time, they still taught and fought for the same faith. Nobody represents this reality more than our Saint of February, St. Leo the Great, Pope in Rome. Leo had received a very good secular education, but was more drawn towards the spiritual life. Because of this, he became a deacon in the church in Rome. Leo would eventually go on to assume the papal mantle in the year 440, a time of great difficulty in the church due to multiple heresies floating around. In particular, he taught against Eutychianism, which taught that Christ was somehow a third type of nature, not just human and not just divine. He taught against Nestorianism, which taught that Mary was not the mother of God, thus denying Christ his full divinity, among other false teachings. He also played a major role in the Fourth Ecumenical Council in 451, where he defended the faith against monophysitism, which taught that Christ only held a single divine nature. It was at this council that the church condemned the teachings of Eutyches, Nestorius, and Dioscoros in favor of diophysitism, the teaching that Christ indeed held two natures, both divine and human, without division or confusion. But we'll save those details in a future episode of Theology Thursdays. In 452, Attila the Hun turned his army against the city of Rome, and St. Leo famously met the conqueror at the gates of the city. Nobody knows what they said to each other during this meeting, but Attila turned his army around and left the city completely untouched. Rumors spread that Leo advised the Hun to think twice about attacking the city of God, and an armored angel appeared from the heavens. Leo couldn't prevent the city from being sacked by Gesseric 3 years later, but he did convince him not to burn the city to the ground. So I'd say that's a win. Leo I was very much beloved by the people of Rome, as well as Christians in the East. The time of his death was divinely revealed to him, in which he prepared for his repose with 40 days of prayer and fasting, before his falling asleep in 461. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like this video, you know what to do. For future content on the Christian Neophyte, hit that subscriber button, and you can also tap the bell symbol so that you'll be notified when the new videos come out. Now remember, run the race with endurance, and I'll see you in the next one. You were the church's instrument in strengthening the teaching of true doctrine. You shone forth from the west like a sun dispelling the errors of the heretics. Righteous Leo, entreat Christ God to grant us his great mercy. Пришила, услуждаю новый закон.